In order for a hearing aid to function at its best with minimal degradation of sound quality, regular cleaning and maintenance of the hearing aid should be performed. This video will demonstrate not only how to clean the hearing aid, but also troubleshoot the most common reasons a hearing aid's performance degrades. Regardless of what type of hearing aid you have, on a daily basis, wipe the outer casing with a dry microfiber cloth. More stubborn dirty spots can be wiped away with a damp cloth. If you have the type of hearing aid with a dome, gently pinch together the opening of the hearing aid dome to squeeze out any earwax that might be blocking the opening. Such earwax may cause the sound volume of the hearing aid to be lower than normal. Following the pinch, gently wipe the tip of the hearing aid dome against a cloth. Never use rubbing alcohol or other cleaning fluids or solvents on a hearing aid as it might damage it. Wiping with a soft cloth or brushing is all that is usually required. If you need something wet, then use audio wipes that are meant for hearing aids. A brush can be used for particularly stubborn areas as demonstrated here. Remove any earwax that may be blocking the microphone openings with the brush as well. Debris plugging the microphone will cause the hearing aid volume to be lower than normal. A brush can also be used to clean the hearing aid dome. If any earwax debris is still clogging the opening, remove the dome. This will expose the white wax guard. Try to remove any debris from the wax guard using a brush. If unsuccessful, replace the wax guard with a new one as demonstrated here. The end of the replacement tool is firmly inserted into the wax guard to remove it. The replacement tool is then flipped, which already has a new wax guard pre-loaded. Firmly insert the new wax guard into the hearing aid receiver. Here is another demonstration of replacing the wax guard on a different hearing aid. After replacing the wax guard, gently press the hearing aid dome back over the receiver. Let's talk in more detail about replacing the hearing aid dome. Dome removal requires a gentle bending motion while pulling it away from the receiver. The dome is seated around a notch at the tip of the receiver. When placing the dome back on the receiver, you're trying to push the dome back around the notch. When properly placed, you should not be able to see the notch when folding the dome away from the receiver. Try pushing the dome further onto the receiver if the notch is still exposed until it is completely covered. Now, if you have a BTE hearing aid where the receiver is contained within the hearing aid shell, the thin tubing between the hearing aid shell and dome may become plugged with debris. In order to clean the tubing, first unscrew the tubing from the hearing aid shell. Next, thread a cleaning wire through the base of the tubing. Push the wire all the way through the tubing and out the tip. This maneuver will push out any debris or earwax from the tubing, thereby removing any blockages. Repeat this process until the tubing is clear. The tubing can then be screwed back into the hearing aid shell. For custom in-the-ear hearing aids, cleaning is similarly performed as for the behind-the-ear hearing aids. Wipe the outer casing with a dry microfiber cloth. More stubborn spots can be wiped away with a damp cloth. A brush can be used for particularly stubborn areas. Remove any earwax that may be blocking the microphone and vent openings with the brush as well. For the vent opening, a tiny curette can also be used to remove any earwax debris located deeper into the vent opening. But do not use a curette to clean the wax guard. Rather, replace the wax guard with a new one. The vent tunnel can be more aggressively cleaned with a vent cleaner probe. Simply insert the cleaning probe into the vent opening and have it come out the other end. Any debris within the vent tunnel will be pushed out of the hearing aid vent with this maneuver.